Tonight, Alex is confused. A switch acts up, and we go over a crossing.
Alright, so what we're trying to do, we're trying to get this piece of shit car, truck, bus, hybrid, train car thing to move itself. And the alternator's been replaced by someone who knows what he's doing, but the job has not been completed yet. So, alternator, we've got positive and negative going to the battery to charge it, but we've got these wires, which comprise of, I have been told, a field voltage regulator. There's three of them. A field voltage regulator and, in quotation marks, something else. So, my job is to figure out, first of all, what the something else is. Second of all, how to wire this all up. And third of all, if we can get away without any of it. So, once that has been accomplished, this thing will hopefully be able to charge itself with electricity while the engine is spinning and not lose ignition, and then maybe we'll be moving this abominable creation. It's some life. Reference, voltage, sense terminal, and the field terminal. The color on the spade connectors doesn't matter. You have to use a multimeter to determine which connector goes to which pin. The R will be hot at all times, all right, while the F will only be hot when the ignition is keyed on. Yeah, well, there is no F terminal on this alternator, which is very interesting. There's an R and an I. So that's interesting. I is for interesting. I is for fuck off. Here you go, Braden.
I is for...
No, stop it. What did I do? Braden.
I think you find some washers,
I don't know. This thing confuses me. Yeah, okay. Break valve. Fine. Oh, is this... No. The grease. I thought it was that engine start stuff.
There's some washers in here. I found some. I think I found the originals, which were now all covered in oil.
Gio, you got a flathead screwdriver down there?
Fuck. I have it in the car.
Oh.
I have my tools in there.
Okay. No problem. Just do what you're doing.
Okay.
No, I got one anyway. Good. Find out what the hell's in here. Bunch of wires. Bunch of eyeballs. What comes up through there? Two wires. What comes out of here? It's a double hammer voltage regulator.
Is that a screwdriver?
That's all it is.
Still need a screwdriver?
No, I got one.
Okay.
All right, field, armature, and what? Battery. Okay. Battery goes to battery. Armature. Now, the problem is because it's an alternator. Yeah, they're trying. Yeah, Gio!
Yeah?
This is why they're blowing up the alternators.
Why?
This is a field and armature type voltage regulator.
Oh.
It's meant for DC machinery only.
So it's feeding the field excitation as a DC field.
Well, no, what it is, it takes the reading off the armature, right?
Oh.
And then adjusts field output continuously. Yes, it is. and it uses the battery as a reference voltage. It's very simple, but it's not meant for a fucking alternator. Well, we could use it. I mean, see, as long as we get... We have to put the sensing signal wire to the armature, because that's going to say, okay, that's the input. You know, I've got 13, I need more. I've got 15, I need less. And then field will be the output. It'll be all wrong because it's an alternator, but it might, I mean, it'll sort of kind of work. Continuity tester in the meter. When we have a circuit, it screams. It's also useful for emergency telegraph codes. So we're going to now trace the wires to the voltage regulator to make sure what goes to what. And what we're going to do is we're going to hook armature up to the sensing line on the alternator. That'll be the voltage readout. And then we're going to hook the field to the field. So it should regulate a bit like a DC generator. We'll find out.
So the motor has the interpoles on this one. So that means the motor does not spark.
Yes, the motor has the interpoles.
So that makes sense why the motor side of the commutator was not, because it actually has interpoles.
All right, Braden, can you hold this wire for me?
But the camera.
I know, you can eat the camera later.
Okay.
So, Alex, get the fucking thing away from me. So you don't know the story.
No, well, if Braden was there, I wasn't there for
all right.
This bit. But so I remember the sand tunnel.
The sand tunnel was the suction uptake for the waterworks.
I know, we were trying to get it open.
Yeah, well, so we didn't end up succeeding in breaking the door open, but like these guys...
You squeezed through it because you're thinner.
Well, they held it open, right?
Yeah.
And then I squeezed through.
You slithered through it.
So I had Beard's phone, I think, flashlight. And I was walking in there, and it was long, a little narrow gauge railway on the floor, you know, and then it, like, dropped off, so it's just the rails suspended in the air over this, like, 20 feet.
Yeah, I could see that back that far.
Well,
I remember that.
And I looked around, you know, there's all kinds of rusted up crap, nothing really interesting, like, no machinery, no way to get into the waterworks. I said, all right. And then I looked up, and I thought, it's funny that the ceiling has a lot of, like, detritus on it, you know, like very irregular features. And then I realized... There's about 10 to the 8th spiders on the ceiling. And if you don't know scientific notation, you know, like you're talking like the number of
That's
stars.
That's not a popcorn ceiling.
The number of stars in the universe, but this, like, instead of stars, it's spiders. And I said, and they were big, like 3-inch, 4-inch legs. You know, like they're called dock spiders, I guess. And I looked up. No, they're not. They are not. I looked up and I saw that, and it sort of, and I took the light down again, and it sort of took a second to register, and I said, oh. And then I said, all right, fellas, I'm coming out real quick right now. I'm coming out. You got to get that door held open because I've got to come out of here. And then they're asking me, like, what's back there? And I was just, oh, I'll tell you when I get out, all right? I'll tell you as soon as I get out. And they held the door open, and walking over the rails, over this pit, I could have fallen down there, and I eventually got out, and I first said, is there anything on me? Because, you know. And then I told them it was, like, literally the origin point of all spiders in the planet Earth. So I'm never going in there again.
Yep, I wouldn't do that either.
It was a very nasty little adventure. Anyway, this is going to be even worse, though. So
when you click those in, it changes nothing.
Well, you know what? I need a third hand.
Just relax there, Jim Jam.
Alright, you didn't... I think you probably verbally...
Well, you see, son, lays are for
probably,
big people, and
probably,
you aren't one, so you can't have one. By the way, Mom says you're grounded. Bye-bye!
By the way, I think it's probably
Jim Jam. What were you saying, Gio?
He probably told me while he was talking to me at one point, which...
Gas engines
well,
are...
gosh darn it. We'll just have to go and consult the owner's manual, won't we, Jim?
Gas engines are for big people, and,
well, you aren't one.
You're a small person. No, and Mom says you're grounded.
So you can't have one. Bye.
Alright, let me see if I can totally make model and make number off that.
You see, Geo, so the sensing one, R. R is sensor. That would be armature. That's the big round one.
Does yes. And main power feed should go to sensor 2.
Croissant? What's that, Geo?
So then the sensor should be on the same bus as the power feed to the, not to the armature, to from the armature to the batteries.
Yeah, well, that's the lead I'm taking.
Okay, yeah.
I'm taking R for, yeah, R is sensing. Can't even remember what the fuck it stands for now. But the R is going to be the armature connector. So I need an adjustable wrench.
Adjustable? Ooh. I had one. I feel it's still down there. Oh, you got it?
Oh.
Okay.
Thank you.
Awesome.
And can I have a light?
So the shop ate my black paint.
Great!
There's gotta be paint.
Is there. Did you check in the flammable cabinet?
They might actually put some.
I would think that they would always put paint in there because people think paint is combustible.
That's cute.
Yeah, well, some of it is, but. Jimmy, you see, son.
I'm gonna put this flavor down someplace.
You see, Jim J.
Mr. Neutron, I don't feel so good. No, Jimmy!
That's better. So that noise, I don't know what that is. It's not the fuel pump, but it's there's no sparking happening in the voltage regulator. Just gotta find out what that noise is.
Try to turn off master.
Nope, leave it on. We have to diagnose. Well, just hold on. All right, brake in emergency, obviously. We need to wait for it to charge. Are there any drain valves on the reservoir open?
Yeah, I'm gonna go check.
No, that's the speed of charge.
Okay. Put you there. We don't need electricity for the turnover.
Yep.
Why the hell is that?
It's a hydraulic reaction with the throttle.
Does it need the engine turning to operate?
No, it's clicking it here.
No, it is acting jammed.
Should be fine.
Wait a sec, where's the other one? In the quadrant or something?
Yeah, the other one was locked.
It's off?
Locked.
Yeah, unlock it. Okay, now I've got it free to move. Very good. Alright, do you want to do the turnover test?
Yeah, let me get outside. I'm going to go look at that.
Okay,
belts.
Very good. 1 sec. Let me just find where the fucking start valve is because I can't remember. It's, somewhere in this mess.
Oh, it was,
It's a whistle valve. Here it is. Ready?
Yep. Turns all right.
Everything look in order?
It turns, but you see how those belts are, right? They're like on an angle.
I do.
So, I mean, if we lose a belt, we lose a belt. But Terry's concern of the, you know, water pump not turning is... Not there, so... Yeah.
Alright, you go there. You go up here. You go there. You go there. You go there. Oh, fuck you!
That actually... That's not working.
Stupid fucking machine. Okay.
Close the...
Ignition is on. Yeah, I know. Well, I have to spray some more.
The fan is running.
Go.
How do you turn
the
fan on?
What the fuck? It's that one.
Okay,
fuck you. Fuck you, train. Now,
they should have fucking closed that before you ignition.
Alright, I think we're running low on battery now.
Yeah, well, I mean, we got...
Yeah.
Not that, but it's...
What's our voltage at?
It's bottom, it's, you know, 9, 10.
Yeah.
But that's fine. It's
well, the last time we needed that battery pack thing.
No, it's a gasoline engine. We need ignition.
We need the battery to be charged. No, I understand that, but it usually kicks like that.
When the battery's that low.
We can grab the charger, but...
We did it with the charger last time. That's why we got it started.
All right, grab that then. But, I mean, we have lights, so I'm just thinking...
I want to open the door.
Phil, listen to me. Go under the car. I need you to hear for the fuel... Listen for the fuel pump, all right? I want to make sure that's operating.
Where is the fuel pump?
You go back toward the tank and just tell me if you hear a motor running, all right?
I don't know. Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
All right, well...
Is it on?
No, it's not on yet. I just want to see... Because right now we've got no registry on this gauge at all.
It was still at
9.
Yeah. What do you got?
Focus.
Well, no, a real number.
9.
Okay, wait. Now we got it.
Yeah, a little tiny bit more. Oh, here's up to 10. We got 10.
Yeah? Okay.
11.
As you can hear, the car is now running. Grab the truck out. Yeah, I knocked it out. So, we need to use this car to move things around today, but we're going to take it on a little test drive.
Wait, you gotta take the clutch out before you change gears.
Yeah, it's out.
Oh, okay, I have your
car. So much.
Got 120 going again.
did some track work, and now we're working on these filthy, horrifying subway car parts in a feeble effort to
look at me. This
subway car going.
And on that crown sheet, it's time to melt. Good night, everybody.
Shut up!
Look at me.
You little slut!
This is my shit now.
I'm going to.